Hi, it's Gadget UK here. Just a quick video on the Nintendo Virtual Boy and emulation and how you can use 3D TVs and 3D monitors to get the best out of that experience, really. I had a play around with a couple of the emulators yesterday, and eventually I found some source code for VBjin. I'll post a link to it in the description. I can't remember exactly where I got it from, whether it was SourceForge or something like that. But yeah, I downloaded the project. I thought I'd have a look at the code, see, you know, see what's going on there. And I found that it was Visual C++, Visual Studio 10 project, so a solution, just loaded it into Visual Studio and hit compile and it works. You know, you can just make tweaks and changes and things, really easy to do that. So I had to tinker with it, did a couple of mods. One thing that I found it was lacking, and this is the reason I went looking for the source, is the colour, the different colour options there. You can have like grayscale, which is, you know, just like, looks like white, really, you know, variations of white, but no redscale, and I thought that was a bit odd, really, you know, that you can't get the actual look of the Virtual Boy there while you're, you know, trying to emulate it on a 3D TV or a 3D screen. So I added the option there for redscale as well as the grayscale that was already there. And I also found that the 3D option, or the 3D settings to do with the pixel offset between the two screens was a little bit inadequate, let's say. I think the smallest offset was 16 pixels. And I was finding that was giving me a bit of eye strain. It didn't look quite right on my screen. It could be because of the aspect ratio difference, you know, I'm viewing this on a 1610 monitor or something, you know, so there's a bit of an issue there. So I adjusted it as well, so you could have a 0 pixel offset and an 8 pixel offset as well. I think I might have been on 12, and I can't remember. I experimented with a few of the lower values until I got down to 0 and realised actually it works pretty well with a 0 pixel offset on an LCD monitor where you look pretty close to it. I guess the other pixel offsets are designed for, you know, sort of further away viewing distances for, you know, TVs and things like that. But anyway, yeah, cut to the chase. Just thought I'd show you some of these videos of, you know, 6 or 7 different games here. So just to sort of sit back and sort of try and enjoy them, really. I realise it's a bit hard when it's just red, you know, shades of red. And if you've not got a 3D monitor, obviously you're going to see two lots of the image there, slightly offset from each other. The way I've done this, and the reason I recorded it that way, I recorded it just as a single 2D image, but I've certainly got a 3D monitor. I know a few other people out there have got them, so I thought it'd be interesting to try and see how it comes out.
We'll be right back.
To upload the binary that I'm, you know, if the changes I've made, just let me know and I'll stick it in Dropbox or something and put a link in the description. I may well do that later anyway, so it's worth checking the notes / description part anyway, just to see if I've done that. Anyway, thanks for watching, and I'll see you soon.